It was a pesky problem. Peter Piper not only picked a peck of pickled peppers, but he was also picky about his pecks. You know, those pectoral muscles in the chest? He said, "I pick pecks of pickled peppers all day long, but I can't seem to sculpt my lower chest. I want that carved from marble look, you know? An interesting challenge." But I had just the program he needed. Of course, we had to get some befores and afters. First, we measured his lower chest, 43 inches. His upper and mid-chest looked fine, but yeah, a bit doughy in the lower part. Then we got to carving. We started with a flat dumbbell press. Pete sat down on a bench, straightened his shoulders, and leaned back. He brought the dumbbells above his torso and started pressing them over the middle of his chest. Since he was a strong fella, I asked him to do 15 reps. Then we did the dumbbell fly. We adjusted the decline bench, which is the best option for a person with strong shoulders, and Pete lay down on it. He bent his elbows and brought the dumbbells up, then back down. I didn't let him lock his elbows, since it would have moved the pressure from the chest to other muscles. We did 15 reps again. Next was the incline push-up. Great for beginners eager to pump up their chests. This exercise becomes less challenging with time because it gets too easy to lift your body weight. But you can do what I did with Pete. We used a suspension trainer. Pete lowered the machine straps to about knee high. Then he got into a push-up position and grabbed the straps. His tailbone was aligned with the back of his head and his heels. He lowered himself down and pressed back up. We did 10 reps. After 1 week, we saw his muscles become more defined. The next exercise was the flat bench press. People often make the mistake of only going for the decline bench press. Sure, this exercise does target your lower pecs, so it should be a part of your training. But if you want to round out your chest and really bulk it up, do flat bench presses as well. You just lie on the bench with both feet flat on the floor. Bring it down to the middle of your chest and press it back up until your arms are straight. We also tried isolating the chest with a pec deck fly. Most of the movement in this exercise is done by applying pressure directly through the elbows. I adjusted the seat so that Pete's upper arms were parallel to the floor. He pushed his shoulder blades back, his lower back pressed against the pad. Then he brought his arms toward the center of his body, all the while contracting his chest muscles. After that, the chest dip. This exercise almost entirely focuses on pumping up the lower chest. Pete hopped on the bars and locked his elbows to support his weight on his arms. While leaning forward, he slowly lowered his body. He kept going down until his upper arms were parallel to the ground. But as soon as he started getting too low, I stopped him. This could overwhelm the shoulders and cause an injury. Pete then went back up by squeezing his arms to activate the chest muscles. The hex press is another must. Pete lay down on a bench with a dumbbell in each hand and brought them to the middle of his chest. Then he flexed his chest muscles, lifted the dumbbell straight up, and brought them back down to the middle of his torso. Besides all those, I also suggested he try a couple cable exercises, since they have a wider angle and provide more resistance. No wonder when Pete tried the following exercises, he felt even more pressure on his chest muscles. We started with the bent forward cable crossover. First, I adjusted the pulleys right above his shoulders, and he stepped 1 foot out in front of the other. As Pete leaned forward, he brought his arms forward too, toward the middle of his torso. Then he went back to the starting position. For better results, he also crossed his arms at the wrists while keeping a slight bend in his elbows. This exercise was more difficult, so it took a couple of weeks until we could add extra weight. From there, we did the decline cable chest press. We moved the cables to the lowest point of the cable crossover machine. Pete lay down on a bench and brought both cables to the middle of his chest. Then he pressed the handle straight up and flexed his chest muscles to extend his elbows. His arms met where his upper abs started. Besides those exercises, he also did some at-home chest stretches. Since Pete was prone to storing fat around the chest area, I knew it must be because he works at an office all day. Sitting like that can make your chest get tighter and your back weaker. To fix this, I recommended 2 chest stretches every day for good posture. Stand in front of an open door with your arms at a 90-degree angle and lean your body through the door frame. And since Pete had a free outdoor workout area near his house, I recommended he hang from a pull-up bar to get a nice chest and back stretch. We did this routine 4 times a week for 3 months. After the program was over, we measured his lower chest again. 48.5 inches, 5.5 inches more than at the very beginning. As for his goal of looking like a marble sculpture, well, what can I say? Peter Piper now has some pretty perky pecs. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.